Welcome to K Passionate. I'm your host, KP, a marine biologist with over a decade's worth of experience working with marine mammals like sea otters. Anyone who's ever seen a sea otter probably already knows that they are extremely cute, very curious, and oftentimes a little bit silly.
That's rude. Oh my gosh, so rude, Caroline.
But one of the more frequently asked questions I see is, how smart are they?
High five. Don't steal that.
So today, we're taking a deeper dive into their watery world to find out the answer. And then we'll dive even a little deeper still to find out how I train our friends like Katmai and even the world famous Joey. But first, don't forget to like and subscribe and head on down to the descriptions below for ways that you can help support the channel. Now, typically, I don't like comparing animal IQs. That's because it's extremely hard to measure, and it often depends on the personality of the animal and what they're being asked to do. Different animals have different skill sets. For example, sea otters are one of the only non-primate animals to use tools.
First, a break.
Now that doesn't necessarily mean they're smarter than dogs, because dogs don't need to use tools. Now, let's take a deeper dive into a sea otter's skill set. Last week, we looked at the natural history of sea otters in this video, that you can find right up here, where we learned that sea otters are a member of the Mustelidae family, or the weasel family. It's a family that includes animals like stoats, minks, and badgers. And two things that every member of that weasel family has are an insatiable curiosity and another thing that I forgot, relentless tenacity. There are reasons why words like ferret and weasel are synonymous with things like search, ransack, unearth, like how we're ferreting out why sea otters have weaseled their way into the hearts and minds of viewers like you.
Oh, that was rude.
Once a Mustelid's curiosity is piqued, they will stop at nothing until they either have what they're looking for, have destroyed what they're looking for, or have used what they're looking for as an object of destruction to the next thing that they're looking for. Psychologists have long considered curiosity the driving force behind not only developments in science and industry, but behind learning itself. After all, the only way to satisfy our curiosity is to explore, investigate, ask questions, and hopefully find the answers. So a sea otter's natural, insatiable curiosity actually makes them pretty quick learners when it comes to behaviors.
Sure. Good. Open it? Yeah. Good. Open. Good boy.
And in zoos and aquariums, this learning sometimes comes from the people that are caring for them, teaching them new behaviors. Like a flipper or a paw present, or even asking them to walk onto a scale so we can measure their weight.
Scale!
Good job.
And even cute behaviors like striking a pose or tapping their paw can be beneficial to the animal because it engages their mind. Because if we're not engaging their minds by teaching them new behaviors, they will find more destructive ways at engaging their minds, usually involving tearing down the habitats unzipping pockets, closing and locking doors behind the keepers.
Open my pocket!
Now, before we dive into how exactly it is we teach the animals to do these behaviors, I want to acknowledge another question that I often get, which is there ever a point at which we stop teaching the animals new things? And the answer is no. Because just like in humans, learning new things keeps your mind healthy and active, and that becomes even more important as you age. Teaching an otter to spin is really no different than doing a crossword puzzle, ou apprendre une nouvelle langue. Another important thing to keep in mind is that we never force an animal to do anything that it doesn't want to, and in fact, we can't. Not only are sea otters closely related to wolverines, but they're actually larger. Sea otters are the heaviest member in the Mustelid family, and they are just as tenacious as their infamous cousin.
Do you guys mind? Are you guys sick of each other?
So if a sea otter doesn't want to participate in the learning, there's nothing we can do about it.
Oh. I'll give you something different. Sorry, is that gross?
But it does become my job as a trainer to make sure that the animal does want to participate in our session.
Well, you gotta get all the way on it. Good.
Okay, so the moment you guys have been waiting for. Let's actually go through how we train these behaviors with something that I started doing with Joey.
Okay, Joseph, here's the deal. We're gonna work today.
I decided to teach a simple spin behavior. So he should sit up in the water and spin vertically, basically until I ask him to stop. The idea is that when I'm done with this behavior, it's gonna look something like this, with Mac spinning nice and slow in the water. You can see that Mac clearly understands this behavior and doesn't really need any helpers from humans anymore. You can also see the same behavior happening here with Katmai. She's a little bit faster than our boy Mac, but the same principles still apply.
Okay, watch. Mackie's gonna show you how it's done. Good boy. Why are you so cute? Okay, Joseph, you got it?
Now the first step for our boy Joey, or for any human that ever starts to learn something, is we have to learn how to learn. Joey has never had to do anything for his food. So the process of figuring something out is completely foreign to him. But don't worry, we'll get there. So first, I start with something called a target pole. This basically acts as a focal point for the animal, so that I can use that to help guide him in the direction that I'd like him to go. That's because I can't simply reach into the water, pick him up, and spin him around. A, that wouldn't really teach him anything. And B, I'd probably get my fingers bit off. The target pole is designed to be a focal point. So what I want Joey to do is to actually target on it. In this instance, with his nose would be great. Now I am skipping a couple steps here. I could spend a few weeks trying to teach him exactly what the target pole means, but I think there's a smart guy hidden under here somewhere. So I want to teach him simultaneously. I think that he can learn how to spin, and that's going to simultaneously teach him exactly what this target pole means. No need for those in-between steps. Operant conditioning is a psychology technique used in humans. These types of techniques do work. Basically, the idea is that we reinforce a behavior that we would like to see more of, and the fact that we reinforce it makes the animal remember it and want to do it again in the future. And if there are behaviors that we do not wish to see, we simply do not reinforce those behaviors. It literally looks like us doing nothing for about 3 seconds, just looking at the animal, and that becomes their signal, no, that's not what we were looking for. Try something new.
Oh, hi! Hey. Oh,
Lady or Grabby? Okay, please.
You can see him working through some things here, but when he gets too frustrated, he just up and leaves. But that's okay. What do I do in each of these instances? I simply allow him to leave. And he realizes very quickly, nothing interesting happens when that happens. It's when he comes back and participates in my session, and gives it a second effort, that he gets those rewards.
Water. Jay, spin. Spin! Joe, come on! Joe, Joe. It's real easy. Good! That was better!
Now, it's important to also remember that frustration is okay in some levels. Joey has never learned much of anything.
Sir? Sir, your bro's not gonna give you any food.
What if I grim his butt?
Especially not if you grim his butt. Spin! Good! You know what?
I'm even reinforcing him if he does a slight spinning motion. Sometimes, even reinforcing him for just simply being patient. Actually, I don't think he was ever patient at any point in time, but you know. This is called successive approximations. I of course can't expect Joey to just sit up and spin around immediately upon learning a new behavior. Think of it like riding a bike. You usually start on some sort of tricycle, something very low to the ground and safe, moving up to a bike that has training wheels on it, and slowly removing those training wheels, until suddenly, you're riding a bicycle. And this is my favorite part of training. Now, Joey hasn't had that light bulb moment yet. You can see, this is still a work in progress. And frustration is part of the process of learning. The same as anything that you've ever learned. Odds are you didn't just sit down like a savant and understand it immediately. You had to struggle for a little while. And that's where we're at with Joey.
Spin! Good boy! That's looking very nice, Joseph! Nice.
And this is another reason why measuring animal intelligence is so difficult. Some animals are better at certain things than others. There's more differences among the individual animals than there really is pinpointable differences among the species.
Looks like you get it. When a professional does it.
Oh, Mackie! Oh, your flips are in the way! Oh, good job, you pretty ballerina!
For instance, my brother is extremely good at math, and I am very science-focused. Now, this doesn't make him smarter than I am, or vice versa. It just means we're good at different things. We have different skill sets, similar to Katmai and Joey. For instance, Joey is actually very, very good at any kind of tactile training, like voluntary vaccines, which are very important.
Team flips? Hashtag team flips?
Whereas Katmai is much better at learning new, complicated behaviors. The behavior isn't finished. Joey is still learning to learn. But be sure to check back on this channel, as we'll be posting updates. You can also head over to my Twitch channel, where we do weekly updates on this and all the otters. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and drop a comment down below. YouTube loves comments. And I'll see you on our next deeper dive. Cheers.
Dude, finish up your pocket snacks. We're gonna do one more. Where it's like just very simple. Try not to bite this. Oh, you guys still got pocket snacks. Eat your pocket snacks. Okay, dude. No, we're not gonna grab it. You're doing well. Sort of. You're standing on the thing. Good. Thank you.
you, my dude? It's been good.
That's actually really nice.
Yeah. You say that like you're surprised.
He's doing good.